Okay, hello everyone. Can you hear me on the call? Got it. Thank you. Hello everyone. Thank you for joining us today for this press conference. We are thrilled to have both the teams here to share the thoughts and experience from today's match. My name is Juan Moreno, and I will be guiding us to the through today's proceedings. Now we are going to start with Leviatán. Thank you guys for being here, and we are going to start with questions on the call. Please raise your hand, and I will call on you. Got it. First question is from Sierra.
First off, commiserations on the loss. My question probably is best for Itopata, but can go to anybody. And I'm just freelance commentator. So the first two match or the two matches you've lost in VCT Champions now have been to VCT China teams, Trace and EDG. What do you think were the differences and the challenges you faced against each of these teams? And was there any overlap in kind of the mistakes you were making or the issues that occurred during each of these matches?
Okay, I can pick up. Yeah, I think there is a couple of similarities in the way that they're trading better than us, and it felt like they played a little bit more together than us, both Trace and EDG. But also EDG, I feel like individually is a lot better, and they're the type of team that if you give them something, they're just gonna run away with the game. So we should know now for the grand final to not do that.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Next question is from Pedro Romero.
Hey guys, first off, commiserations on the loss. Tough way to go down today against EDG. I'm gonna throw this question over to King. A two-part question. Obviously, I want to look over into 11-10 or around 22 or around 2021. I'm not sure, I can't remember where you guys had that 4v2 situation. Obviously, that didn't go your way, and by EDG winning that, it kind of served as a turning point in that final map going forward. And so that said, I want to ask you what went wrong in that round, and also how did that then kind of play a role in just the effect it gave for this team from that until the very end of the series.
I think at just some point we kind of got like a little bit rushy, so we weren't being that clear in our comms. So as my coach said, they were just playing a little bit more together. They were shooting hard at the end, and it happened.
Thank you. We'll take the next question from FD News.
The race, sorry. Thank you, Leviathan, for your time to be here. I wanted to proceed to do a question for Mazno in Spanish. Gracias, Mazno, por el tiempo. Quería preguntarte más o menos acerca del pensamiento del partido de hoy. Comenzaron con una gran ventaja en el primer mapa, pero después con el cambio de lado comenzaron a igualar. Y a tal punto en el segundo y el tercer mapa a ponerlos contra la espada y la pared. Quería preguntarte dónde crees que fue el punto de quiebre para ustedes y el comienzo de la ventaja de Edward Gaming.
Yo creo que como dijo King, en el primer y último mapa tuvimos como un momento que nos empezamos como a desesperar, por decirlo así, y empezamos a jugar menos juntos, empezamos a hacer como más hero play y dejamos de jugar como nuestro juego y jugando juntos como equipo. Y yo creo que eso nos terminó costando que no, casi nos empaten o nos ganen el primer mapa y que nos terminan ganando el tercer mapa.
Perfecto, muchas gracias.
Thank you. We'll take the next question from Grill News. Hi, go ahead.
Hola, buenas, soy Finita Mede del medio Grill News y quería hacerles una pregunta, o sea, quería partir más que nada diciéndoles que a pesar de la dura derrota de hoy, muchos fanáticos de Leviatán se levantaron en la madrugada para verlos jugar, apoyarlos en cada partido, y Leviatán se siente muy orgulloso de ustedes. ¿Cómo se siente el saber que tienen el apoyo tan dedicado y qué mensaje les gustaría enviar a todos esos seguidores que estuvieron ahí con ustedes siempre? Ahora la voy a hacer en inglés. Latam is very, very, very proud of you, and I wanted to know which message and how do you feel about all of this dedicated support that you have gotten during these championships in general? This question is for anyone from Latam, kiNgg, aspas, or Mazno.
Bueno, obviamente muy feliz de que toda la gente se levante a apoyarnos, que es súper tarde el partido, especialmente ahora que inclusive es más, un horario más complicado. Y nada, siempre, verdad, su apoyo se siente mucho, siempre en los comentarios, en la historia. Así que nada, de verdad. Todos estamos muy agradecidos, inclusive los que no son de Latinoamérica, como los son Tex, como o Ito, Yuv, también sienten el mismo apoyo y de verdad como equipo estamos muy muy agradecidos y nada, vamos a ir dándolo todo en lo que queda el resto del torneo y eso.
Muchas gracias.
Thank you. We now have two questions from the Korean media.
네, 아스파스 선수와 텍스 선수에게 질문입니다. 2세트는 EDG의 빠른 속도에 고전한 것 같은데요. 경기 이후에는 어떤 피드백을 했는지 궁금합니다. Okay, this is for aspas or Tex. You seem to struggle with EDG's fast game pace in map 2. What kind of feedbacks were going on after the match?
Wanna take it? It's all you, buddy. Second map was a little hard for us. They kept exploring your C on the start of the game. We took some time to adjust to it, and when we adjusted, they started going A. So it was a little hard the second map.
네, 아스파스 선수가 대답해 주셨는데요. 2세트는 조금 어려운 경기였고 EDG가 저희의 C사이트 공략을 되게 잘했다고 생각합니다. C사이트 공략, EDG의 C사이트 공격에 적응을 완료했을 때 EDG가 반대로 A사이트를 공략을 해서 그런 부분이 되게 어려웠다고 얘기했습니다. 다음 질문은 마지노 선수에게 감독님과 마지노 선수, 감독님 또는 마지노 선수에게 질문인데요. 플레이오프 첫 패배로 패자조 결승으로 향하게 됐는데 쉽지 않은 센티널즈 혹은 헤레틱스 상대로 최종 결승 진출을 위해 어떤 부분을 분석해야 할지 궁금합니다. So this is for the coach or Mazino. So you lost today and have to face either Sentinels or Heretics in the lower finals. What kind of things do you need to focus to win that match?
Ito, I think it's for you.
I think that was for you, buddy.
You're a
Okay.
better person to answer.
Okay. I think we need to focus on our fundamentals a lot more, because I think playing on the big stage kind of made it a little bit harder for us today, and we made some very some mistakes that we would usually never make, and I think those were in like key rounds, and that really costed us. So the second and the third map. Even th there was a lot of those mistakes on Icebox. So I think just focusing on our fundamentals would be enough for us.
네, 일단은 기본기에 집중을 해야 할것 같다고 하셨고 큰 무대에서 플레이하는 만큼 적응하는데 조금 어려웠다고 생각하고 그 중간중간에 나온 실수들이 중요한 라운드에서 나와서 2, 3맵이 되게 어려웠고 아이스박스에도 솔직히 많은 실수가 있었다고 해서 그런 실수들이랑 기본기에 집중을 하면 충분할 것 같다고 얘기하셨습니다.
Thank you. We'll take the next question from Sierra.
Yes, hello again, Sierra Freelance Caster. My question is for Calm. We saw on Twitter and in the broadcast that both Jaw and Potter are here in Seoul for VCT Champions. Did they get to chat with you, like hype you up or anything before the match today or in the last few days? And what is it like having them here to support you as the last member defending your Champions title from last year?
Yeah, I mean, I've talked to them a little bit. Always good seeing them. Yeah, I mean, it's really nice to have that type of support, especially from, I guess, like my old team. But obviously, like, I'm focused at the task at hand. And yeah, I would say overall, I'm happy that they're here for me, but I'm still focused on the current goal.
Thank you.
Thank you. We'll take a question from the room next.
Hello, I'm Via from Nerditude. Mi pregunta es para King. Primero que nada, lo siento mucho por esta difícil derrota. Siendo la primera vez que llegas a estas instancias de un torneo y en un estadio donde no eran el favorito, ¿cómo sentiste hoy este primer juego aquí en el estadio y si vieron nervios que tal vez pudieron afectar al equipo y su resultado hoy?
Bueno, la verdad es que estaba súper emocionado por jugar. Creo que al momento de pisar el stage y sentir como la energía, la verdad es increíble. Y nada, yo creo que no creo que hayan sido nervios. Yo creo que fue un poco más la presión de haber querido como cerrar el partido rápido, lo que nos terminó costando más que nada, no en sí los nervios. Y nada, eso, creo que fue una derrota muy dura y nada, hay que resetear y concentrarse ya para el partido de mañana.
Thank you. We'll take the next question from Arnab.
Hey guys, likewise, congratulations on the loss. My question is for aspas. This is the second time you have personally faced EDG. Last time was in Champions 23. You were playing with Laude and you guys won against them. But I want to know, as per your experience, how much the team has changed the previous time you have faced them, and today you have faced them. Although there isn't much changes on their roster, but personally, in your opinion, how much changes have you feel from their side?
That was the third time that I play against them. I played two times last year. Now it's the third. I think they kept the same play style. That is a very aggressive and crazy play style, and I like it. Last year I won one time and lost one time. Now I lost again, but maybe we meet again in grand finals, and then we can have our fourth match.
Thank you, and looking forward for next match. Thank you, guys.
Thank you. We'll go next to Andres from Prensa Esports.
Good evening, guys. Sorry for the loss. My question is for King. Hola, King. Tengo mi pregunta sobre cómo te sentiste en este segundo y tercer mapa. Vemos que EDG es un rival muy complicado de leer porque suelen saltarse humos y cosas así. ¿Crees que te viste superado por las decisiones que ellos hacían y no pudiste llegar a adaptarte bien a este segundo y tercer mapa? ¿O fueron ya otros factores que determinaron la derrota?
No, yo creo lo mismo que dije antes, que creo que la desesperación de tratar de cerrar el partido o de como saltarse pasos, por así decirlo, nos terminaron costando como los fundamentos de estar atento a las jugadas locas que hacen. Y nada, más que nada muy frustrante haber perdido como el partido de esa manera cuando literalmente lo teníamos ahí en bandeja, así que nada. Como dije antes también, a resetear y a concentrarse ya para el partido de mañana.
Muchas gracias y suerte en el partido mañana.
Gracias.
Thank you. We'll take the next question from Codigo Esports.
Hello, my question is for Mazno in Spanish. Mazno, me gustaría saber si hubo algo que lo sorprendiera en el planteamiento de juego de EDG, tanto en composiciones o selecciones. Y saber también cómo han trabajado la parte del mental para que duras derrotas a nivel emocional como la de hoy no afecten a próximos encuentros.
Bueno, yo creo que en tema de composición y como estaban jugando, yo creo lo principal es que hacen como jugadas, entre comillas, locas, que al final terminan funcionando porque no tienen miedo a nada, no tienen miedo a hacerlas. Y en tema de planteamiento de juego, lo único compo que podría ser como extraño, por decirlo así, es la compo de Lotus, que no supimos adaptarnos bien dentro del juego. Y luego la última pregunta. Hay que resetear nomás y mañana se juega de nuevo. Nuestro trabajo es resetear, volver a focusarse en el partido y dar lo mejor.
Thank you. And we'll take the final question from Pedro Romero.
Yes, this question goes out to Calm. Obviously, when I'm sure the team lost today and you guys are going down to the lower bracket, but it's not like you've been in. It's not like this is the first time you're in this position. Obviously, looking back into Champions 2023, EG lost to PRX in the upper bracket finals to go down to the lower bracket final. Obviously, we knew what happened at the very end of that tournament. So, as you guys now Prepare for tomorrow. Face whoever comes your way, whether it's Sentinels or Team Heretics. As someone that has been here before, what do you think the team has to focus on most of all when it comes to just preparation, just kind of moving on from today and just having to come into tomorrow with a clean slate?
Yeah, I mean, for me personally, I would love to go from the upper bracket and just get to the finals, you know? I don't think I've ever gone from the upper bracket. So I would say the only thing we really need to focus on is, like, as Ito said, like, fundamentals and playing together. Obviously, it was a hectic game, and you can kind of see that from the outside. But I think if we kind of just calm ourselves and play how we play, you know, how we've been playing this whole tournament, I think we'll be fine, you know. I think the best teams come from the lower bracket because they've been tested so much in high-pressure situations. So, yeah.
Thank you. We had a couple more questions come in. We'll first go to Claudio from Alerta Geek.
Hi. First, sorry for the loss. It was a really good game to watch. And my question is for Tex. Tex, you had a great performance during the matches, put on maps like Icebox. The team had several occasions where one of the opponents looked. Do you handle the option of holding and marking with your abilities at the expense of entering with your team?
Yeah, it's definitely like something I have to think about in the round, if I should be playing my utility or if I should be fighting. It's definitely hard to tell sometimes what exactly I should be doing in the round, if it's better for me to run in or for me to play my util. So really, that's the thing about being a good Sentinel player, really, is figuring out when to do it and what to do. And yeah, just gotta play it by feel.
Thank you. And we'll take the final question from Andres from Prenset Esports.
Hi again. My question goes to Mazno. Hola, Mazno. A pesar que esta pregunta sea un partido anterior, recién es que pudimos ver las voice comms de parte de Leviatán, el partido contra Heretics. Vemos que en el Sunset, donde iban 4-8, todo el cambio de lados lleva solo una kill y en la pistola te hace 3 kills y King te procede a decir buena concha de tu madre y como te dice, that is the smile that I like for. Y desde ese momento pasaste de esas 4 kills a 17 kills con 12 muertes y 9 asistencias. ¿Crees que ese apoyo gigantesco que te dio King y Com te ayudaron a sobrepasar el mal momento? ¿Cómo fue ese cambio mental entre la primera mitad y la segunda mitad?
Obviamente, la razón fueron ellos más que nada. El apoyo realmente me ayudó bastante. Y yo igual sabía que necesitaba como una ronda buena mía para volver al juego y se juntaron las dos cosas y volví completamente al juego. Y se notó. Y se lo agradezco, obviamente.
Leviatán, thank you so much for taking the time to speak with us today. We'll be right back with the next press conference.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.